આવું એટલે કહે છે. Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about role of fine and performing arts. I think I'll wait for this to join. So, role of performing arts and visual art is something unique. It talks about not only the art in the classroom, it talks about the overall personality development also. Today, I'm going to share the significance of fine and performing arts in the classroom. Being an IB teacher, that is International Baccalaureate, I will talk about a little bit experiential learning as well. But before we start, what is art? Art is unique. If we start talking from the birth of the child, when a child is not sleeping at the night, the mother sings a song, and that song brings the deep sleep for the child. Same way, when we talk about our houses, you will see the young child doing something on the wall, writing something or maybe drawing something. It's very difficult for us to understand what the child has put on the wall, but for him or her there is something. And now what is that something? That only that child knows. But yes, this is the beginning of the art. If we talk about the sign and symbol in our classes or in day-to-day life, it has some meaning. For all this, I would like to say that the co-curricular activities are not only the main source of learning, but yes, we can definitely incorporate the visual art or dance or drama with what we call theater or the music. Everything we can include in this performing and fine arts in our classroom. I belong to Kellerex Olive International School, which is an IB school. We follow mainly experiential learning and transdisciplinary and interdisciplinary concept. We call it IDU. Now, where we incorporate different subjects and make one unit. Over there, the role of each subject is unique. If we talk about, say, consumer awareness, we had one unit. Over here, the INS is talking something. Over there, the maths is talking something, maybe some analysis, data analysis, or some ratio proportion. You can talk about the rules and all. But yes, over there, if we act out something, then the concept will be more clear to the students. But now, what I'm talking right now is not about only the role play. There is a difference between role play and theater in education, or performing arts or visual art in the education. Right? So when we are talking about this multidisciplinary course, what happens is the student gets the concept clear by visualizing. Okay, I'll tell you something. Try to remember any one song which you like the most. You remember all the words, right? You might have listened that song for 5 times, 10 times, or even lesser than that. At times we learn the song only like by listening once. Why? Why it happens? Because it stores in our brains, right? Now, to show something to the children, what we do is normally we try to role play. What is dance? What is the collaboration between dance and any, say, subject, let's say, maths? The student over there is learning steps. Nowadays it has a beat also, so indirectly or directly we have music also connected. It has beats 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now if we teach the same thing to a KG kid or say lower grades, they learn this steps, they learn this mathematical rhythmic order also. If we talk about a visual art, so like if we talk about visual art, the student, he is knowing the decision making power. If he has that decision making power, what he or she will do? He knows exactly which color to use at which article. Like you will not see a tree having, say, purple color if it's a neem tree. So that decision is there. Now the same thing the student will implement in his or her regular class using other subjects. We tried one unit with my mathematics faculty using this dance and theater. It was all about the dimension, angles, perspective. Now, if you talk about the theater, you know that the actor has to move 3 steps and there will be a different light area. If he is changing his place, he will be out of focus. So this way, all these art forms are helping each other. I would like to show something to you. I think it will let us know that how this theater, dance, music, and visual art helps us to understand fast. For this, because of this lockdown, whatever resources I have, I tried to collect something and show something. So there might be something which is like below the expectation level. For that I regret, because I'm using the resources like a power bank and some remotes and some printouts and maybe a rostrum or something. So we'll see. For this, I would like to thank 2 people. One is our music faculty, Mr. Shardul. He has helped me by providing some music. What music, I'm not going to disclose now. And second, my wife, she helped me for making something which you are going to show, see in some way. Now, this is one example, a very small example of theater in education, how we can use. I'm just using normal things like a remote or a power bank, which you have in our classrooms. Maybe for our AC, we have the remote control and anything. You can use duster as well. This is just a small message. And I'm using the resources which are with me right now. So Again, I beg your pardon if there is something which is missing. Like I know you will see my hand. Actually, when you are doing some performance like this, you should not be visible where I'll be visible. Let me start something. But yes, I think the concept is clear with all of us that if we use such puppets for some serious cases like the corona, what I have done is I have just taken some small papers and some cutouts with different moods and the corona image. And what happens? Ultimately, Yali comes. He suggests to use mask, and yes, the corona is gone. Now, this is just, as I told you, I'm just using this small equipments, or you can say the props, which help me to show that yes, we can make difference. Now, hope you like, I would like to acknowledge again, Mr. Shardul, for providing the song, and I've done a little bit of editing with the same song. Sorry, I'm managing the screen after the puppet show. Yes, so what I was talking is nothing but the theater in education and performing arts and role of visual art. Now, with this puppet show, you saw the puppets moving, that is visual art, the theater. Even I tried to manipulate with some dancing movements, and of course there was a music. Now, this makes our life simple. How? Because a difficult question, if I would have to take a science class and if I have to explain that, oh, if you are stuck with corona, you will have this, this is and that and all, but no, just small images help us. So this way you can incorporate the art forms in your regular classes. Because corona is a sensitive case right now, sensitive issue, that's why I try to use it. But yes, if we go back to the role of all these art forms, it is giving you confidence, not only to the students, but to the teachers also, because we don't have to hunt for the subject related content all the time. You can use these devices to make your class more interesting, to make student understood better, and at the same time, we can deliver what we want to deliver to the students. It gives the self-confidence to the students also, because they know exactly what they want to convey. At times, we have different students which we have to take care of them specially. We have sent policies also in our schools. But yes, for every time, all the students, it is not handy for them to write and deliver. Over there also, when I'm talking about the assessments, yes, it helps us. Like the student who is not able to write, he can communicate in this manner also. Let us go to the next thing. It is the integration of subjects. As I already mentioned, you can not only integrate the performing arts or the visual art with one subject, but you can have multiple subjects also. This was just a small demo to show how we can incorporate different forms. It was, you can talk about the scientific reasons behind this, or you can talk about the community where you saw some kind of depression or some ill people. So different integration of subjects is possible. One more thing is talking about the fun element. At times, with due respect to all the subjects, what happens is sometime with some unit, it becomes boring. And such dance forms or some element of visual and performing arts help us to make the class more interesting. It is problem solving also. If the student is knowing the distance and the dimensions, like using the theater or dance or even visual art, he or she can definitely take help of this subject to make his fundamentals clear with the base subject. If we talk about the cooperation or the collaboration, yes, definitely we can take example of all these art forms, and you can, in collaboration with others, you can create something else. As I mentioned, we at the Kellerex Olive International School, we follow the IB International Baccalaureate. We have IDUs, that is interdisciplinary units. So different subjects come together and then they create something, and we plan and we execute with the students. Of course, students are also involved in the unit planning and all. And we come out with something unique, and the fundamentals are clear, the concepts are clear, students can easily understand this. One more thing is the decision-making power. You can use this art forms and make the child strong enough to have his own decision power. As I told you, like if we talk about visual art, we have to have the proportion. Like today in this show, deliberately I use the corona image, a broader one, and yes, our dear Yali was the biggest one. Now this is why? Because I wanted to show the impact of Yali, impact of corona, and the mankind, so the humans. So this way you can have the proportions even with the color. I'm not talking about only puppet show. You can, when you are creating some drawing, you know the colors, which color to use, or what steps to be taken in dance form, or how to deliver the dialogue, how to modulate your voice, what should be your pitch, what should be your tone, everything they will come to know. So when it comes to some presentation skills, that level, he or she is not only confident, but he knows with what pitch or what level he should speak. And yes, of course, the stage fear goes. So the child is very confident what he or she has to deliver. Now, if we want to connect some subjects, how we go? I'm not talking about only connecting the subject, but yes, it's vice versa. With theater also, we, or dance also, or visual art also, when we talk about, say, Renaissance is the unit, and we, four subjects can work together. We can take example of from the INS, or from the history part, or from the geography, and we can make it simple for understanding for the child. There are certain theater and dance games also which help us to connect with the units. Like if we talk about India's freedom movement, for example, with due respect to all the history teachers and all other subjects, what happens with us when we are teaching the history? Now image, if we have certain characters or certain stories or certain moments there, if we want to show the Dandi Yatra, can we just make a dance form? Or if we want to show the other era, if we talk about, if we want to talk about Akbar, or if we talk about Tansendi, suppose in history, in Indian history, we can use the musical part. That is what the one of the main intention is. Beauty of this is that we can take help of other subject to deliver our subject. At times, what we do in IB, that even though suppose the unit is of science or chemistry, the other teacher comes as a guest lecturer if it is not IDU, and he delivers with his way. So the concept is very clear with the student. It is not that they have to simply mug up and write with the pen and the paper. They have to be clear with the fundamentals and with the clear understanding. One more thing comes in my mind over here is the aesthetics. What happened with the aesthetic at this level? The student, this aesthetic is not only in terms of visual art or drama. It's talking about aesthetics of this subject knowledge. He or she doesn't have to hunt for number of pages and all it at the time. Yes, like the way we write in the bullet points, we can simply use it in our class. Now, one question you might be having, in the meantime, like if you have any questions, you can post, I'll try to answer at my best. But yes, so the question arises that this all gadgets what I used are just simple printout or some sketches or some puppet like Yali, or what we are using in the class. This can be one of the questions, that how I can use this in my class. Now, we have some resources already available in our classroom, like We can simply use a dupatta and you can show about the civilization. Like you can use simple clay. Like one of my colleagues, he made a wonderful sculpture. It was just a simple night out over there. And he just saw some clay and he is expert in that. But I'm not talking about only expertise over here, because there are two things. One is the direct subject, whether it is fine art or performing art or visual art or dance or drama. But I'm talking about incorporating. So whatever resources, like if we want to show some beard or say Mughal age, we can simply use some cotton and we can show the beard. You can have the hair in those connections. I would appreciate if you have any questions so that I can answer. I'm just so yes, I have the proportion of this subject. Yes, that matters a lot. When we have a visual art or a performing art class, your focus should be more on your theoretical and practical aspects. So you should know that to what level you are addressing. And of course, over here, the level means the grade and the level means the subject knowledge also, as well as your role. As I told you, the aesthetics, right? The value base, the music, poetry, theater, all has its own boundary, you can say the level. So you have to be within your limits. That is one thing. And each child has uniqueness. Like we are talking about multiple intelligence over here. So you are indirectly or directly addressing this multiple intelligence also. And then you can deliver the best to that child. I can see some questions over here. Okay. Someone has asked, okay, when we are talking about its query about something related to science, how we can use this forms in the sciences. Yes, there are certain definitions, there are certain concepts, like let us talk about Newton's law. Or let us talk about Archimedes. You can actually put into the practicals and you can show us. Of course, there might be some limitations, but yes, you can definitely show this to the students. If you have any questions or any query, I would appreciate. I'll try to give whatever little knowledge I have, because it's already nearly half an hour. So I also have to manage the time. So if you have any query, I'm welcoming those queries. Okay, someone is asking about talking about the role of PE as well. Okay, the physical education, of course, I'm supposed to talk about the fine art and the performing arts, but yes, the PE also has a major role in not only the decision making or the self-confidence, but yes, even the social connections also, cooperation also. So yes, each subject has its own value. With this, one more thing what we can cover is the memory. Normally, as I repeat, normally we see some students just mugging up and then they are just writing on the paper or whenever they have to. But yes, the application is less that time. What happens is your visual image stores, I mean, it helps you for a longer period of time. If you, your memory is definitely increased, you have the, as I told you, the fun, the problem solving method, you can have the communication skill as well, and it helps in multiple dimensions. Okay. Yes, the theory of theater or performing arts or visual art, yes, it gives you empathy towards each other also. This is a good example has been given. Yes, you have the empathy towards each other and towards the students. Even the students will have empathy for the faculty member also, the teacher also.